Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to use Visual Studio Code for Java programming. So I am going to show you how to write a Hello World Java program on Visual Studio Code and how to run that on Visual Studio Code itself. So to watch the video till the end, I can guarantee at the end of the video you will be in good position to create any Java projects on Visual Studio Code and to run and debug everything. So to watch the video till the end, if you face any issues, you can always comment on comment sections, and I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there. You can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'll definitely going to help you. So now to use Visual Studio Code for Java, you'll basically need two things. One is Java and Visual Studio Code. So let's install Visual Studio Code first. So go to your favorite browser and just simply type over here Visual Studio Code download. Hit enter. So that going to show you this code.visualstudio.com. So just simply click on this download Visual Studio Code. So that going to redirect to official site of Visual Studio Code. This link I'm going to provide on our description. Here, depending upon what operating system you're using, you need to download it. For Windows, I'll just simply click on this button. Thanks for your download, and our Visual Studio Code is rightly started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. And next thing that you will need is Java. So Visual Studio Code already provides one coding pack for Java. So yeah, when you are already in Visual Studio Code, you need to just scroll down over here. You will see Java over here. So click on that and click on getting started. So that going to show you this getting started with Java in VS Code. So they have really created a very beautiful article. You can always read this entire article here when you scroll up. So here you will see this install coding pack for Java for Windows. If you are using Mac, you need to proceed with this one. For Windows, I'll just simply click on this, and you will see that coding pack for Visual Studio Code is also rightly started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this, and this link also I'm going to provide on my description. So once you download both these two product, so you can see that coding pack and Visual Studio Code both are rightly downloaded. Once when you download it, it's time to install it one by one. Let's start with Visual Studio Code. Double click on the installer. Read this license agreement, accept it, and click on next. So check all these options and click on next. So ready to be installed, click on install, preparing to install, and Visual Studio Code is rightly started installing. So by the time that Visual Studio get installed, I'll request you please to consider subscribing our channel Geeky Syntax. So here also regularly I'm posting lot of coding related videos. So if you subscribe, that's going to really motivate me to make more similar kind of videos. And also, if you're interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script vlogging channel. So welcome back. You can see that our Visual Studio Code is rightly installed. Also, launch Visual Studio option is rightly selected. Click on finish. So that's going to launch our Visual Studio Code. You can see that our Visual Studio Code is rightly launched. So let's close this. Next thing that you will need to do is to install this Java coding pack. So just double click on the installer, and it's going to show you this install coding pack for Java installation wizard. Let's minimize our download directory, and here you need to accept this license agreement and click on next. So here you can see that our Visual Studio Code is right already installed, so there is OK option to Visual Studio Code, but Java is not installed, so we need to download and install Java. So that is the actions that it's going to provide. It's going to download Java, install, and also it's going to install all Java extensions. So you don't need to manually find the extension and install. So everything it's going to do this coding pack itself. All right. So yeah. So just simply hit install and just sit back and relax. So it's going to download your Java and going to install it. Only thing is, it's going to download JDK 17. You can see it is downloading a little older version. If you want to install very latest versions, for that I have already made a video. So this video will teach you how to install the latest version of Java JDK 23. So if you want to upgrade it, you can always watch this video, but you can still use with this version that going to also work totally fine. All right, if you are especially starting and starting off with Java, you can work with JDK 17. It's stable version and decent version. All right, so yeah, let's wait for some more time over here. So in middle, it's going to ask you to provide administrative privileges. So just simply click on yes. So you can see it is installing our Java. So let's wait for some more time. So we'll come back. So now you can clearly see that our coding pack for Java is rightly installed. Also launch Visual Studio option is rightly enabled. Just simply click on finish. So that's going to launch our Visual Studio code. So yeah, it is rightly launched. You can also verify whether Java is properly installed on your system or not. So for that, just simply go to search and type cmd to open your command prompt. And within command prompt, you can always type java space dash dash version and hit enter. So that's going to show you this open JDK version 17. So yeah, our Java is rightly installed. As I have told you, if you want to install latest version of Java, that else you can do it. Just follow this video. Alright, so now that our Java is rightly installed, also all extensions are all are also rightly installed. So if you go to extensions, you can see all these different extensions like debugger for Java, extension pack for Java, Gradle for Java. Everything is already installed, alright. So everything is taken care with that coding pack. So only thing that you need to do now is just programming. So go to Explorer. You know, you can create a Java project also. You can also create open folder from here. So let's click on this open folder and let's go to our desktop and let's create a folder and let's name this folder as java-workspace. Alright, so just select that folder, click on select folder. So that's going to open this Java workspace folder over here. You can always click this I trust the authors and all. So our Java workspace folder is rightly opened over here. Let's click on this icon to create a new file and let's name this file as hello world.java. Hit enter. So that's going to open this hello world.java file over here. So let's write a simple Java program over here. So class hello world and let's write main. So that will give you suggestion of this public static void main. So just simply click on that. So immediately we'll see public static void main string args is rightly populated. So that's the benefit of using these extensions, right? So this this Maven, then project manager for Java. So all these extensions, then test runner for Java. All these extensions help you to writing your Java code much faster. So now that I'll just simply write, let's say print. So immediately we'll get a suggestion like system.out.println, right? So you double click, immediately you'll see that it is populated, right? So enter thing, you don't need it to write to system.out. So that's the benefit. Let's write hello world and let's go to file and save this file and click on this run button and you can see that our it is rightly started running. It will ask OpenJDK platform binary, click on allow and you can see the output already coming on our console, hello world, right? So in this way you can easily use Visual Studio code for your Java projects. So that's basically all about this video. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel Geeky Syntax, and also I am posting lot of videos on WordPress, WooCommerce, so I'll highly recommend you to watch my other videos as well on this channel. That's going to really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. So yeah, that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.